Now, motorists wake up to a big price hike in petroleum products today, as much as 1 peso, 30 centavos per liter in diesel, 95 centavos per liter for gasoline. Now, the latest round of hikes bring this year's total increase in gasoline so far to 13 pesos and 75 centavos per liter. For diesel, that's 11 pesos and 70 centavos per liter. And in kerosene, to 6.24. Based on data from the Energy Department, the cheapest gasoline can be found in a Flying V gas station along New York Avenue in Cubao, selling it at 57.60 per liter. It notes a price war seems to be going on in the area as rival gas stations monitor each other and bring down prices to win customers. Now, those looking for the cheapest diesel in Metro Manila, well, you guys should head over to Refill Juan Luna in Tondo, which sells it for 58.70 per liter. Meanwhile, Regasco President Arnel T. estimates a small cut in LPG prices come November 1st. The Philippines' pension system slightly improves but still lags in the latest ranking by Mercer CFA Institute Global Index for 2023. The country ranks 46th out of 47 countries in the list, closer to Thailand, Turkey, India, and Argentina. The rankings are based on three factors: adequacy, which asks how much a beneficiary gets and is that enough; sustainability, whether the system can keep delivering; and integrity, if the system can be trusted. The agency recommends increasing the minimum level of support for the poorest aged individuals, setting aside funds in a public system for the future to reduce reliance on the pay-as-you-go system, and introducing non-cash-out options for retirement plan proceeds. Overall, though, the Philippine index value still went up from 42 in 2022 to 45.2 this year due to increased coverage. Meanwhile, the Netherlands, Iceland, Denmark, and Israel top the list for their first-class and robust retirement income system that delivers good benefits that are sustainable and have a high level of integrity. Tech company Grab will be partnering with financial services and digital payments company Maya to promote cashless transactions in the Philippines. Grab Financial Group Philippines announces starting November, that's next month, Grab users will be able to pay using Maya.
Starting November, we will be partnering with Maya, wherein their users can now seamlessly pay for their favorite Grab app services through the use of their wallet. So that means us integrating the Maya wallet into the Grab app. And this is a great partnership wherein Maya and Grab will be pushing the digital transformation agenda to promote cashless penetration in the Philippines. So we're happy to really partner with, collaborate with like-minded partners such as Maya, and being able to help Filipinos follow the cashless movement. Aside from really pushing the agenda of the Banco Central ng Pilipinas in terms of promoting,
Grab Financial Group Philippines also set to represent the Philippines along with other local fintech firms in the upcoming Singapore Fintech Festival, which will run from November 15 to 17. Now, esports have been a big thing for more than a decade and were even part of the recent Asian Games. And now, they're about to become even bigger. Saudi Arabia has announced the launch of an annual Esports World Cup, which will include the most popular games in the world and have the largest prize pool in esports history. Clubs will compete across games from various genres to become the ultimate Esports World Cup champion. The competition will be held in Riyadh starting summer of 2024.